across the harbor.
Go.
Good, good.
Right there.
Let's go, let's go.
Overhead.
On the Brenna A.
Start of a new season. Got to get out there and go fish.
When you got through king and bear dye season pretty well, made enough money to buy the new boat under the pretense that we were going to get fishing right away. And instead, it took 3 months, $30,000 later, and the boat's just sitting at the dock. It's ridiculous.
Yes!
Because fitting out the fishing vessel determined for the Bering Sea took more time and money than anticipated, Sean's expanded fleet has been more of a burden than benefit.
He was hoping to get it up here to start fishing and crabbing, but it's sitting at the dock, and when you're sitting at the dock, you're not making any money. Now we gotta make money for two boats.
Instead of producing, his new boat is costing the young skipper $12,000 a month.
The whole point of buying this boat was to expand the business, expand the family legacy, the empire, and make money. Add to the revenue stream, not take away from it. And that's what's happening right now.
Now that the plan to boost his business has backfired, Sean has been left reeling.
I've got 330,000 pounds of opies to catch.
No!
Fire! Fire! Come on, come on.
Damn it!
Me. What was that?
I was testing the bilge pump. I've only had it running for like 15 minutes. I didn't think it was gonna light on fire almost.
Pull it out, go get a new one, I guess.
The bilge pump ensures that water inside the hull is pumped out of the boat to prevent it from sinking. Keeping the pump in working order is crucial.
The little things, right? I mean, that little thing could have turned into a big thing, could have turned into an even bigger thing, and this whole operation could have come tumbling down all at once. I'm so glad that Zach tested the pump at the dock and it burned up here, but still, it's $5,000. Went in big with that new boat. It's just all those little drops in the bucket that's adding up dollar by dollar. We gotta hit it hard and fast. I need to get to the Opie grounds right away.
Back in Dutch Harbor.
I'm in a hurry to get out there and get the pots and to go Opie fishing.
On the Brenna A.
Pay some bills, get a little bit of money in the bank.
Eager to compete against the winter season, Captain Sean Dwyer has one last stop at the pot dock before heading out to the Opelio grounds.
Boat's running well. From all that we can see right now, everything checked out except for the one thing that didn't. It's a bilge pump motor that burned up. We've replaced it. Moving on.
Yeah, we're in Dutch. Get pots for opies. Gotta get her done.
Ben, you're good. Just pulling into the pot dock. Busy here.
Oh, yeah, Brenna A.
Just down the dock.
Coming up, hold on.
The Summer Bay crew rigs their last Opelio pots.
Brandon, give us a little slack.
Yeah, two. Okay. Back in action. What's up, OJ? Right there.
What's that? Is that flash?
Ow!
Whoa!
Are you all right?
While helping the Brenna A tie up, deckhand Nick McGlashan falls, injuring his ankle.
Ow!
On the icy, unforgiving dock.
Ow!
Hey, Bill, you there?
Yeah, what's happening, Nicky? You guys still ringing?
Hey, I got some bad news.
Nick just twisted an ankle, I guess. I can't take much more this season.
Oh, man, the pain is spreading up to my knee.
Yeah.
Yeah, this isn't good. Kind of need you.
Only 12 hours before the season start, an ankle injury could put an end to the summer Bay's departure plans.
So, I don't know, we'll see what it looks like. Cut his boot off and put ice on it. See what happens in the morning, I guess. Take him to the clinic.
Already heading out to sea with three new crew members. Captain Wild Bill may be forced to hire one more.
I felt like pretty big pops.
You want to stabilize for a minute? You want to
sit?
Yeah,
I'll go in there and just.
Sorry, guys.
We'll get it wrapped up. We'll get you up there in the morning, get an x-ray. This is ridiculous. I mean, he's my heart and soul out there. If there's a way for somebody to make it, he'll do it. That's the way he is.